So here we are, we're at the brand new Queensferry Crossing. A lot of years of hard work have gone into the building of this project, and we've got exclusive access really to see it in all its glory. We've seen the inside, the outside, we've walked all the way up here to the middle tower there, and just in a few days there's going to be cars coming along this exact same roads. And at the weekend, some of you lucky people will be walking across this exact section. But I've got a fact sheet here in front of me with some of the more bizarre facts about the bridge. I'll tell you some of them. Okay, so 23 kelpies could be built using the same amount of steel required in the build of the North and South viaducts. And 200 Boeing 747 planes are the equivalent weight of the amount of steel required for the bridge deck. So that just shows you the scale of this project, and an exciting few days coming up when cars finally go across it.
The design of the windshield, and I'm glad you used the word shields rather than barriers, because a barrier would be bad news. The sort of oscillations that it was set up in the deck would be unacceptable. The other thing with barriers is that it creates turbulence across the deck, and sounds a bit, you'd have to see a mathematical model to understand that. So that's really why we have the grille nature of the shields, because it acts like a ventilation grille in your house or your home. It actually controls the flow, and it doesn't have the sort of turbulence, the gustiness that you get on the Forth Road Bridge. It's not just the speed of the wind, it's the way it sucks and pushes all the time. Gustiness.
And for people that have been driving across the Forth Road Bridge for as long as they can remember, one thing that people, you know, will remember is going across and the bumpiness of the road, the doof, doof, doof as you go across. But this is very smooth, and it will be very different. It will feel very different, won't it?
Well, if you're an electric car, I think you'll really wonder whether you're moving at all, because there are no joints on the bridge, except the two very large expansion joints at either end. 2.7 kilometres apart. But the other thing, the road surface itself is a very, very low noise road surface. Unfortunately, on the existing road bridge, it's not just a bum 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 bum. The road surface is very thin, and it has to be a sort of an epoxy material. And so therefore, it can't have inbuilt into it some of the low noise characteristics that our road surface will be. So there are two things, really. One is the surface, and the other one is the lack of joints.